So Dr. Ravi Arora, how do you feel after every 15 minutes when you get to hear thank you for inviting me? So in this thankless world, after every 15 minutes, since yesterday I'm seeing everyone on the stage, the first thing that they say is, thank you, Dr. Praveen Arora. Wow. How can we create a community like this where we take a center stage and every time people look up to us with respect? They give us respect not because you are doing some kind of favor to them, but they give that humble respect because you genuinely deserve that. And that is from where I come, from that space of how can I create a space around myself where there is more of genuine people around me and more of genuine support I can get. I come from an investment banking background, and I was a forex analyst and an investment banker for a decade. A completely male-dominated society. Someone from Paris, Deepthi, right? She said she lived in a world dominated by men. World of computers. I come from the world of finance, completely dominated by men. There are many stories. I was the only female member in the team, and there were many stories. I'm short of time. The bell will start ringing. So I'll get into those stories, but one thing that I realized that in those years of my work experience, I enjoyed money, I enjoyed abundance in life in all parameters, I enjoyed everything because of one single factor. No one around me took a career break. I come from the space where men around me believed in working hard and partying hard at the end of the week. When I got married, I just underwent 2 months of career break. And I relocated from Delhi to Bangalore. In that 2 months, I got to hear many times a simple but a fancy word. It's a very fancy word. I was actually blank when I heard it for the first time. I heard it repeatedly and then I thought, okay, let me look into the dictionary. The word was a woman on a sabbatical. A woman on a sabbatical, and I didn't know the meaning. Why? Because I was around men most of the time, working hard, partying hard, not knowing what career break is. And that's when I took a career break of 2 months. And I realized that there is a constant tag which is given to women. I was very young, maybe 5 to 6 years old, when my father tagged me with the word rebel. Somehow I felt good about it, I don't know why, but maybe some years later I got the answer. I didn't accept things very easily. And when the investment bankers and the organizations started offering me the paycheck that was way below, 35% down, to the check I was receiving, I was very comfortable in saying, no, I don't want this. I want, if on a career break of 2 months, if I can crack an interview, along with a guy next to me who's not taking a career break, then I think I'm more capable than him. Sorry guys, please don't get personally, but that's how I felt. So I said no, and that no, the 2 months turned out to be 6 frustrating months. Then I realized, let me do something about it in that space for women who are on career breaks, who are on fancy world of sabbatical. I started interacting with women who are in mid-career, who have just entered into the workforce and also on a career break. I started interviewing them, helping them to scale themselves up and also take decisions before they leave what is the future vision after they want to join once they come back from the workforce. This webinar of mine turned out to be a good response from women on a career break, and then eventually I plan to start my own talk show. And this talk show is all about creating a holistic approach for women to get into the workforce back again. It's a platform which is virtual. It is recognized by Your Story as a creative idea in the metro city. It is a platform which is recognized by Words of Wisdom and also by some other marketing agencies. We are trying to create a community of women who want to get back into the workforce, and right from the most basic necessity, that creating, redesigning your resume to interview skills, how to perform, how to speak when you are in a meeting surrounded by all men, and many more other factors. Our only intention through this talk show and through mentorship program is to make them a little more rebel, a little more cautious, and a little more aware of what they want, and not to come up with any kind of excuse, but realize that you are in a world where you need to step up, step out, and think out of the box. Thank you.